Hello everyone, and welcome to a new video on my channel. I'm recording this video in English today to make it accessible for a larger audience other than just German-speaking people. Because I'm at a very special site today. I'm about 80 kilometers north of Amsterdam, the Netherlands, at the Wieringermeer wind turbine test site, which is a test site for wind turbine manufacturers to build their turbines, do all the necessary testing, collect all the data that is needed for the later serial production of their wind turbines. And the main reason I came here today is the turbine on the left, which is Enercon's new flagship model, its latest addition to its portfolio, the new Enercon E-160 EP5. Enercon's new EP5 platform features three different turbines. There's the E-136, which is designed for high wind speeds, the E-147, which is designed for medium wind speeds, and then the E-160 that you can see here, that is designed for low wind speeds, which also explains the largest rotor diameter in Enercon's current portfolio of 160 meters. So one blade is almost 80 meters long. I think 78.3 meters is what I read. Yes, so the turbine was completed, construction was completed a few weeks ago. So I was quite hopeful coming here today that I would see it spinning. Unfortunately, that's not the case, as you can see. It looks like they're still in the process of connecting it to the power grid. I was seeing some cables lying around, so I guess they're not quite ready to commission it yet. But still, it's pretty awesome to be here and see the turbine up close. As some of you might know, in 2017, Enercon bought the Dutch wind turbine manufacturer Lachawe, which also produces direct drive wind turbines. As Enercon was seeing itself at a very critical point in its history, as the German market was collapsing, less and less wind turbines were being built in Germany, and in the past Enercon had really focused on the German market instead of going a lot more international. So Enercon decided to buy Lachawe, which I guess was a beneficial merge for both of the companies, as they were able to share their expertise and knowledge and move on together in the future. Looking at the wind turbine, there is really very little, if nothing, that reminds you of a traditional or characteristic Enercon turbine, with the X-shaped machine house and its characteristic rotor plates. But what this turbine is basically a Lachawe turbine with an Enercon logo on it. The turbine was built on a modular steel tower with 120 meters hub height, which was originally developed by Lachawe and is now being more and more utilized by Enercon for its current EP3 platform, for instance, and in the future is going to be more and more used for the EP5 platform. Moving a little closer, you can really see the different sections of the modular steel tower that were pre-assembled on the ground and then put together to the tower. The machine house itself does really resemble the Lahaway turbines. Minor adjustments were made. It's not quite as rounded as the Lahaway turbines, but a little bit more edgy. And it does remind me a little bit of the old Enercon E-40. The nacelle is quite large, with a huge generator behind it. The rotor plates, unlike being produced by Enercon itself, as for its other turbines, the rotor plates were not produced in-house, but they were produced by the rotor plate manufacturer LM. That's a Danish company. I guess that's all part of Enercon's turnaround program, as it calls it, of producing all the components for its wind turbines more efficiently and cost-effectively. And then that a part of it is also to give away the production to other companies to outsource. The turbine that was built here is the E1 version of the E160 prototype, which means it has a power rating of 4.6 megawatts, which is supposed to be increased in later versions. At the end of this year, Enercon plans to erect another prototype in Germany at the wind test site in Grevenbruch in North Rhine-Westphalia, with a fundamental ramp up of its power to 5.5 megawatts, which is then the E2 version of the E160. And like globally, there are already a lot of projects that have been signed with this turbine type. Yeah, it's really quite unfortunate that it's not spinning yet. Like, I would have been really excited to see it spinning, but I guess there are other people coming here who might film. So I guess I'll see it then. Right next to the E160 is one of Enercon's other prototypes that was built here over a year ago, the beginning of 2019, which is the Enercon E-138 EP3, which is part of Enercon's new EP3 platform. This is the E1 version with 3.5 megawatts up high, 35 meters. In the meantime, Enercon has already prototype the E2 version of this turbine with 4.2 megawatts, and I've already seen a lot of projects using this this new turbine, the E1 version as well as the E2 version. It still is one of my favorite turbines by Enercon right now, especially the E1 version with the bigger nacelle. I don't like the E2 version quite that much, but I do really like the large generator with the small machine house. Compared to the EP5 platform, the EP3 platform does really resemble the old Enercon E40 quite much, and you can tell that it is an Enercon turbine, unlike the turbines from the EP5 platform. But But with both platforms, the EP3 platform as well as the EP5 platform, you can tell the trend that Enercon is moving towards more efficient production and cost-effective production of its turbine parts to dramatically reduce the cost of energy. Next to the EP3, there's another prototype by GE. That's surprisingly being dismantled already, which is a prototype of GE's new Cypress platform that was built here just briefly before the Enercon EP3 was built here. And it's really taking me by surprise that it's already being dismantled. It hasn't been here that long. Well, but I guess they've done all their testing. The first turbines have been commissioned in bigger projects. So I guess it's time to make way for a new prototype. The rotor plates are already on the ground. They're also quite large. So this is a 5.3 megawatt turbine, 158 meter rotor diameter. The machine house, it's still on the tower. I mean, it's really debatable whether this turbine design is pretty or not. I guess this was all about cost-effective production and not so much about beauty. It is really quite large and like... it's got a weird shape. I don't know. I'm curious what happens to it. Maybe it's being rebuilt in a different project. It's being disassembled here at the wind test site and then it's being rebuilt in a wind farm. I'm not sure. Yeah, at the back, there are several other wind turbines by other manufacturers. There are a couple of Nordex wind turbines, N117, I guess. There are quite a few of them on my way here. I saw quite a few Nordex N100 and N117. Then there's a couple of Vestas turbines, the 112 or 126, I'm always unsure with the Vestas turbines what exactly they are, because they all look very similar. And then there's another Enercon turbine at the back, which is, I think, an Enercon E-126 EP8. So quite a large turbine with 7.5, either 6 or 7.5 megawatts, I'm not quite sure. Which is also, unfortunately, not being manufactured anymore. Here's another great view on the construction site of the GE turbine that's currently being dismantled. GE's Cypress prototype. From here you have another good view on the rotor plates again, which are also really quite large. They're almost as large as the rotor plates of the E-160. And they do look really alike. I'm not sure if they're even the same rotor plates or I'm not sure if LM really manufactures and customizes them for the individual turbine manufacturer, or if LM produces the rotor plates in like different length and sizes, and then the turbine manufacturers can choose based on their desire. I'm not sure about that. Maybe you guys know. Another view on the pretty machine house. You can see the logo quite well. Wow, it just looks like a huge container. Again, a view on the beautiful Enercon E-138, and then the E-160 next to it. Yeah, I guess that was it from the wind test site, Wieringermeer in the Netherlands. It was quite fun to explore here a little bit. I wanted to film from the other side as well to get a different perspective on the wind turbines, but I came here by train and bus from Amsterdam, and I also need to go back. So it was quite a hustle to get here because I don't have a car. Yeah, but I hope you got a good impression of the wind turbine test site, and especially of Enercon's new flagship, the E-160. And yeah, I hope you liked this video. If so, give me a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram. There is a link in my YouTube profile. Alright guys, I guess I'll see you again in my next video, wherever this might be. Maybe in the Plek Forest, most likely. Until then, take care, and I'm excited to see you next time. Bye, guys.